man worships, he honors with beauty. His temples he adorns with the work of his hands. In this act of beauty is an act of worship. Craftsman and devotee, chisel and chant. All these unite in homage at the ancient feet of Jainism. Jainism is one of India's oldest faiths. Its teachings are like the art it inspires. As stone can be cut to the wonders of sculpture, so man can be chiseled to a perfection of soul. Hence, Jainism's teaching of austerity and renunciation. The Jains do not believe in God as a creator. They worship their Tirthankars. Tirthankars are souls who attained omniscience and established a new order of life. They are to Jain temples what the divinity is to shrines of other faiths. The last Tirthankar lived and taught some 2,500 years ago. He was Lord Mahavir, the great victor. On this site, a small flame closed his mortal life. But the eternal sun of his spirit lives on. Around the holiness of his Tirthankar, the Jain wove the beauty of his shrines. To fashion them, he made nature an architect and a devotee. These are the cave shrines of Udaygiri and Khandagiri in Odisha. They go back over 2,000 years. Through wisdom, man passes to enlightenment, and through enlightenment, to the serenity of the Tirthankar. The same eternal message is carved on the rock at Badami in Mysore, Mathura in Uttar Pradesh, and Ellora in Maharashtra. For the interiors of early Jain temples, the craftsmen chose wood. The delicacy of work that wood allowed forever set the style of Jain temple ornament, even when later shrines used the permanence of stone. Jainism's finest temples were built between the 11th and 15th centuries. But this was not just the age of the architect. Structure inspired scribe and painter too. From deep in this temple at Jaisalmer, Rajasthan, has come a treasure of palm leaf manuscripts. The Jain canon is in Ardhamagadhi. This was the popular language of ancient Bihar in which Lord Mahavir taught. It is now the sacred language of Jainism. A great richness of miniature painting, too, has come to light at Jaisalmer. These miniatures depict the visions of a mother whose son will be born at Tirthankar. The Jains have crowned the hills with temples. To them, high places are holy. Here at Shatrunjaya in Gujarat, as elsewhere, the Jain hills offer up whole cities of temples to the sky. At Shatrunjaya, there are some 500 temples of rock grouped in 9 tongs. A tong is a constellation of temples around a principal shrine. In one temple alone, there are some 6,500 carved figures. Mountain Theatre at Shatrunjaya is dedicated to Lord Adinath, the first of the 24 Tirthankars. Other concepts, other styles. The Jain architect broke with tradition and evolved the Chaumukh or four-faced style of architecture. People enter the shrine from doorways open in all four directions. In all four directions face the Tirthankars. Lord Adinath, residing Tirthankar at Ranakpur in Rajasthan. Pillars. The architect needed them. The craftsman transformed need into ornament. At Mount Abu in Rajasthan, Jain temples grew to perfection. The Vimal Vasahi temple is a cool marble flower at the feet of Lord Adinath. It was built by Vimal Shah at a cost of 180 million rupees nearly 1,000 years ago. Thousand years have tiptoed through this shrine, touching but not defacing, passing but prayerful as a devotee. the Loon Vasahi Temple, a sister temple of the Vimal Vasahi. This carving was produced by no ordinary chisel, but by scraping. The marble powder removed by the craftsman was the measure by which he was paid in gold. It has been said that the main dome of the temple dooms to futility all writing about art. It flowers into a unique icicle of marble. This miniature tells of Neminath's first step towards enlightenment. On his way to be married, he saw the animals to be slaughtered for the feast. He turned at once from his marriage to a hard courtship of truth. This temple honors Lord Neminath, the 22nd Tirthankar. Love is man's highest emotion. Man's image is its sublimest adornment. But here the human image soars above its earthly forms, touched with the glory of worship. It moves to the rhythm of a life eternal, in honor of the Lord. Salvation is the lonely work of single souls, says Jainism. Alone, man must set his spirit free. Man is body and spirit. Only one is eternal. Visible and invisible, two worlds meet in man. Visible and invisible, two worlds meet in his temple.